Chapter 7. The Kingdom's Fall. Jeremiah 39, 29-1-23. Sparks flew from the burning temple. Citizens ran screaming through the streets. Children wailed for their parents. Soldiers dragged the king and his officers to the outskirts of Jerusalem. The great city was suffering. The Babylonian king Nebuchadnezzar and his army had swept through town like an angry whirlwind. The Babylonian soldiers did their job, destroying everything in their path, capturing the people, eating their food, scaring the children and elderly. When the chaos settled down, Jerusalem was ruined, empty, and scorched, the city walls broken down. Smoke rose from the smoldering houses. And on a nearby hill stood old Jeremiah the prophet, shedding his tears for the city he loved. Crying for the Israelites he tried to save. Why wouldn't they listen? He thought. Jeremiah cried, remembering how hard he tried to warn the people. Turn back to God. He had told them over and over. But they ignored him and chose to disobey God. And now the people were being carried off to Babylon to become slaves to the king. King Nebuchadnezzar had spared Jeremiah. The old prophet had one last message for the people. Despite his tears, Jeremiah felt a new hope for the future and he wanted his friends in Jerusalem to believe his words. Don't give up hope, the prophet urged. The Lord is good to those whose hope is in him. If you truly seek him and wait patiently, God will save you. The sad and suffering people of Jerusalem needed Jeremiah's words. His tears showed them he truly cared. And his words gave them courage in the years ahead, to wait patiently for God to rescue them and return them to their homeland.